Hi, this is Jeff Kitchen. I'm the surface water specialist for the data section in California. I would like to talk about the SAT conversion spreadsheet, which can be used to convert data from an azimuth stadia survey, typically obtained using a laser or optic engineer's level, into the Cartesian coordinate format needed for input into the IRIC program. The IRIC SAC program is the preferred software platform for running the USGS slope area computation 1D model, otherwise known as SAC. This program requires input data that are in an XYZ format, or to be more specific to our surveys, an easting, northing, and elevation. If you are using GNSS or a total station for the survey, you can easily create an input file from the instrument in this format. However, if you are surveying with a laser or optic level, your data will be in polar coordinates, which are measured using angles and distances and will need to be converted. Let's open the SAT conversion spreadsheet and take a look. The first sheet, named Survey Data, is where you will input your field data. The second sheet is the plan view plot of our data. The third sheet, named Output, is where the macro creates the final output file. There should be no need to change or interact with anything on this page. The last sheet, named README, contains some of the basic instructions I will be discussing in this video. It also contains my contact information if you have any questions or issues regarding this spreadsheet. Let's take a closer look at the survey data sheet. Data that are input into the yellow highlighted cells on the left are converted into the XYZ format, which can be seen in the gray cells on the right. Let's start with Hub 1. Since this is the starting point of your survey, the angle and distance will be zero. The elevations of the hubs are not used in the plan view or the computations performed by the spreadsheet, and therefore are not required. However, I recommend entering them for consistency between the field notes and input file. Enter a remark if you wish. If you have additional hubs, enter those now. The program assumes that Hub 2 was surveyed from Hub 1, Hub 3 surveyed from Hub 2, and so forth. When one enters the angles and distance on the shot of Hub 2, the program will calculate a coordinate for Hub 2 based on the coordinate for Hub 1. Proceed to enter the hubs in the order they were surveyed. You can enter up to 7 hubs. The spreadsheet can be modified if more are needed. Once all the hubs are entered, we can start entering the rest of our survey data. The note column is the name of the surveyed point. A specific naming convention must be followed as described in the SAC tutorial. Angles can be entered as decimal degrees or degrees in minutes. If entering decimal degrees in the degrees column, simply leave the minutes column as zero. The remarks column is where we can enter details related to the point, such as fair debris line for a high water mark. Enter a number in the hub column corresponding to the hub from which that point was surveyed. For example, if all of the survey was done from a single setup, you would simply enter a 1 for each point. When all the points are entered, click on the plan view sheet to see a plot of the XY coordinates. Due to the auto-scaling feature of the plot, this plan view may not be to the same scale along both axes, but it should allow you to check for any obvious entry errors. If you see a point that plots in an unexpected position, double-check the entry and modify if needed. The points will most likely plot on both sides of the axis. To avoid negative values, we can add an offset to our coordinates to make them all positive. We add this on the survey data sheet using the offset cell. The value entered is added to both the easting and northing coordinates. We can see in this example that adding an offset of 300 causes all the values to be positive. Once all of your points have been properly entered and adjusted, you are ready to export the data. From the survey data sheet, simply enter a file name into the highlighted cell and click the blue Export File button to create the output file. We now have a file that is properly formatted for input into the IRIC and SAC GUI programs. If you need help, contact your field office chief, surface water specialist, or indirect measurement specialist.